Benvinguts a Barcelona!
This week, the Foodie List travels to Barcelona, Spain to taste 11 amazing local dishes. On our list, potato omelette, capipota, angry eggs and ham, calçots, crayfish, crema catalana, paella, chocolate toast, cod ratatouille, squid balls, and black sausage and green peas. Four hot-blooded foodies who love to eat as much as they love Barcelona take us on a discovery tour of Catalan cuisine. One by one, they'll taste some unique Catalan dishes. Spanish cuisine is all about the sea and the land, and its unforgettable flavors will take you to seventh heaven. Barcelona. The name alone is enough to inspire travelers with dreams of Mediterranean festivals and passionate food. The capital of Catalonia is a beautiful seaside city that offers a lot more than just delicious tapas. The Foodie List will introduce you to traditional Catalan food and its reinvented cuisine, thanks to a culinary escapade that takes us to a host of restaurants in the most incredible parts of Barcelona, from the beach right up to Montjuïc. Foodies, prepare to be seduced by Boqueria Market. Go for a stroll through this market to dive into Catalonia's culture. It's here that you'll feel all the city's energy. Then take a walk along La Rambla, the legendary pedestrian street that takes you from the port to the Plaza de Catalunya, or Catalonia Square. Enjoy a lunch on a terrace or a picnic in one of the many public squares. Take in the art of Antoni Gaudi or sit back and admire the beautiful architecture of the buildings that he built throughout the city. Catch a view of the sea along Barceloneta Beach and walk to the heart of the city. Barcelona is breathtaking and beautiful. Accompanying us today are four local foodies. Olivier Marquez de Brito is a mad scientist of flavors and founder of foodieamateur.com. Lisi Yuk is the artistic director and creator of the In the Mood for Food blog. Marta Garreta is a blogger for the BCN Foodie Guide. Ricard Martin is the editor-in-chief of Barcelona's Time Out magazine. And now, let's begin with our first dish on the list of Catalonian cuisine, bacalla amb samfaineta, or simply, cod ratatouille. Cod is the essential element of Catalonia's cuisine. Historically, cod was always known as the only affordable fish eaten by Spain's working class. That's why cod was cooked in many different ways. Prepared with vegetables only brings out the best in fresh market cuisine.
Bueno, me llamo Luis, soy el chef de La Pubilla. Nos encontramos en Barcelona, en el barrio de Gracia. Para hacer un buen bacalao en chanfaina, lo primero, un buen bacalao, unas buenas verduras de la zona y, por supuesto, un poco de aceite bueno de aquí, de Tarragona. Luego iremos echando en este orden las verduras. Primero usaremos cebolla de Figueras, que es de una zona de aquí, de Cataluña, ¿vale? Y luego añadiremos pimiento del Maresme. Después continuaremos con los calabacines. Y ahora procedemos a echar lo que es la berenjena. Bueno, ahora solo nos faltaría echar el tomate. Entonces, vamos a coger este bacalao. El bacalao, vale, el bacalao viene de Islandia, pero el truco es quién lo desala. Entonces, el desalador local, que mejor lo hace, bueno, es un señor que trabaja justo enfrente de La Pubilla y tiene un bacalao este que es súper famoso, que es un bacalao de Torres. Y es genial. Es un bacalao que te lo puedes comer así, totalmente crudo. Cogemos un plato como este y vamos poniendo chanfaina así. Para que se vea una buena chanfaina tienes que ver que cuando está toda la verdura así, tiene que ver que está guisada, que está bien hecha, que es un conjunto todo. Acabaríamos con un chorrito de aceite de oliva para que le dé este saborcito. Pues aquí tenemos el famoso bacalao con chanfaina de La Pubilla que a todo el mundo le gusta desayunar en Gracia.
The traditional breakfast has greatly evolved in Barcelona over the past few years. Once upon a time, you probably wouldn't see a lot of Spaniards eating a big breakfast at 9 a.m. The opposite is true today. La Pubilla is located in Plaza de la Libertad, or Freedom Square, near Libertad Market. Come by foot and be seduced by this charming area and you'll taste some authentic cuisine.
Il n'est pas encore 10 heures et je suis avec mon petit verre de vin et mon poisson.
As crazy as this seems, this is breakfast.
Originellement, les pêcheurs, les gens du marché qui se réveillent très très tôt, avaient besoin d'un petit déjeuner bien fort, bien consistant.
Samfaina comes from the word symphony. So it would be like a symphony between all these little vegetables that you find here in this wonderful sauce.
Moi, ce que j'adore dans la cuisson de la morue, c'est qu'il soit cru à cœur, en fait. Il est vraiment fondant. Regardez comme il brille. C'est translucide, quasiment. C'est vraiment délicieux.
It's so good. The skin is very crunchy. And the texture of the cod is just amazing. Cod is a very popular fish in Catalonia because it was cheap and it was very easy to get.
À la base, c'est le poisson qui a permis aux navigateurs espagnols de survivre dans les mers. Pourquoi? Parce que c'est un poisson qui était séché et salé et qui donc pouvait se conserver à l'air libre avec le sel. Ce que j'apprécie énormément de la poubilla, c'est que ce plat, en fait, très 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 traditionnel, mais grâce au chef, il a su lui apporter un petit peu de modernité, trouver les bonnes saveurs. On a vraiment l'impression que c'est la cuisine de maman.
It's a new place, but it kept all the tradition of Catalan cuisine. And among these traditions, we have fork breakfast. This is how we call it, esmorzar de forquilla, which means any kind of breakfast that you're going to use your fork to eat. And also, you can have it with wine or beer. Crazy, but it's like this.
Our second Barcelona dish, crayfish and onions. This is one of the most popular dishes along the Spanish coast. Sometimes the crayfish are replaced by shrimp, but the idea remains the same.
Soc el chef Ferran de la cuina d'en Garriga de Barcelona. La cuina de Can Garriga és una cuina tradicional catalana. Doncs mira, començarem tallant la ceba aquesta, que és una ceba de Figueres, que és una ceba especial d'aquí de Catalunya. Oli d'oliva té que ser, sobretot, oli d'oliva, perquè bueno, li dona la potència a la ceba, doncs, i el gust particular català i a la part espanyol. Anem a saltejar els escamarlans. Vale, doncs pujarem els calamars aquí a saltejar. Una miqueta més d'oli. Sobretot el soroll aquest, el crispatejar aquest que fa, vol dir que anem bé, que el foc està fort. Vale, això, en un període de 3 minuts, ja estarà. Molt bé, doncs bueno, la ceba ja està confitada, que té que quedar una consistència que té un color així transparent. L'únic que fem ara és agafar i abocarem la ceba aquí dintre i li farem un parell de saltejades. Aleshores, posem una mica de ceba al fons del plat. Val, doncs ara el que sempre nosaltres posem al plat, n'hem fet una mica més, però sempre posem unes 6-7 peces. I res més, posar-li una miqueta d'oli perquè brilli i ja està a punt per menjar.
La Cuina d'en Garriga is located in downtown Barcelona, and it's part gourmet shop, part restaurant. With a full supply of bocadillos, the menu list is quite impressive. Nearby, you'll see a stunning and colorful example of Gaudi's unique architecture. And if you have some time, it's worth a visit.
What we have here is something really delicious and really traditional from my country, and I have to take off my ring, and you'll know why.
Oh my God, look at this. Perfect Catalan crayfish.
For some people, I know it's disgusting because it's the anthems, the legs, it's all curled.
This is much cheaper than lobster, and we could say that it has nearly its delicate taste.
There's two ways of eating the crayfish. One is with your fingers.
You just crack the shell and go on and suck the tail. Oh, Jesus. This is just pure flavor.
I'm the kind of maybe classy girl who wants to do it with the cutlery. It's a little bit more difficult. See? There you go. It is really tasty. It's like butter in your mouth.
And once you are done with the meat, the best thing to do to remember its delicious flavor is to suck on the head.
A lot of people would say, hey, are you crazy? This is the best part. But I'm like, that's the brain inside. I'm not eating brain. No, thank you.
And then you can say that you have just defeated the crayfish.
Si no veniu a Barcelona i no proveu això, que esteu bojos. Oh! Girls, don't forget to have your ring back, or your husband will think something strange has been going on.
The third item on our list is paella. Its origins are traced back to Valencia, but now paella is found pretty much everywhere in Spain. In fact, these plates of flavorful rice served with meat and seafood play an integral part in the diet of all Spaniards. At Martinez, the chef prepares his paella with a variation of fish broth and round rice.
Soy Cisco, soy chef del restaurante Terraza Martinez de Montjuic, aquí en Barcelona. Restaurante de temática marinera con nuestra especialidad en arroz y marisco. Hoy vamos a hacer un arroz típico que es el arroz señorito. Es un arroz de todo el producto y apelado que el cliente solo tiene que comer y disfrutar. Empezaríamos con un poco de el sofrito base, ¿vale? Que es un concentrado de sofrito con pimiento, ajo, azafrán y tomate. Pasaríamos a nuestra marca de sepia, que es como si fuera un guiso de sepia, también con muchas horas de cocción para que quede todo tierno. Pasaríamos a un poquito de lo mismo, pero con calamar. Gastamos un calamar muy bueno de costa. Un poquito de nuestro tomate concentrado. Es un tomate frito, natural, hecho por nosotros, con un poco de pimentón, ¿de acuerdo? Luego tendríamos el concentrado de ñora. La ñora es un pimiento seco. Para finalizar, tenemos el concentrado de gamba, ¿vale? Que esto lo utilizamos con la gamba roja que gastamos para el arroz. Lo trituramos todo y hacemos como si fuera una velouté. Hacemos como una velouté que tiene toda la esencia a la gamba para el sabor de marisco. Y empezaríamos con la mezcla del arroz. Este sería nuestro fumet de marisco. Tiramos aquí. Normalmente nosotros le damos unos 7, 8, entre 7 y 10 minutos a fuego fuerte. Luego lo bajamos 3, 4, 5 minutos a fuego flojo y lo acabamos en el horno. Nosotros, llegados a este punto, ya tenemos el arroz seco, como nos gusta a nosotros. Ponemos un poquito de este rape, un poquito del mejillón, mejillón de roca, y luego la gamba roja. Bueno, nosotros le damos siempre un toque de aceite de oliva en crudo. Es nuestro, yo creo, un poco nuestro toque personal, ¿vale? Y le damos un toque de perejil o de cibulet. Bueno, pues esto sería el señorito para dos personas, elaborado en la Terraza Martínez de Barcelona, para disfrutar.
Martinez is located at the summit of Montjuic, a hill that overlooks Barcelona. The view is splendid, and it's the perfect spot to catch a sunset and go for a leisurely walk in the gardens of the famous terrace. Martinez is the perfect place for a romantic dinner for two, or for happy hour and dinner with friends.
Well, it's a little bit cold right now, but that's something that I really love about this place. There it is, blanket, to keep you warm. But I'm sure this is gonna be the thing that is gonna make me warmer.
Merci beaucoup. Il est arrivé. Ce fumet, ça sent super bon.
Oh, I love it. No words.
Il a une belle couleur. Pas une couleur artificielle avec des colorants et tout ça. Ça sent la Méditerranée en fait. C'est vraiment le plat, un plat de la Méditerranée typique.
You can tell when it's a good paella or a good arroz mariné when you can feel that strong flavor of the broth.
Super saveur. C'est un véritable poème de la mer en fait ce plat.
This is one of my favorite dishes. I could eat it every day. It's really nutritious.
La paella, la vraie, l'authentique, elle vient de Valence. Historiquement, c'est une paella avec d'autres ingrédients. Du lapin, on va retrouver du poulet.
Fish, it was quite expensive 30 or 20 years ago. So it was something really festive, something to invest the family money into a dish to share with all the family.
Regardez ce riz. Il est magnifique, il est rond, il est savoureux. Que demander de plus? Essayez-le.
In my right, you have Montjuic. This is one of our city lungs. There are a lot of gardens to have a promenade, to walk. And if you're here, please come to Terraza Martinez. That's where we are.
Si vous avez déjà mangé des paellas de couleur orange, ça n'a rien à voir avec ça. Ici, là, c'est une bouchée de saveur exquis.
The potato omelet is the fourth dish on our list. Known in Spanish as tortilla de patatas, in Catalan, it's called truita de patatas. This dish is part of Spain's great culinary tradition. Every family here has a secret recipe, but everyone agrees that the key are the potatoes and their cooking time.
Soc Josep Maria Marín, el cap de cuina del restaurant Raf Bar de Barcelona. Avui a Raf Bar farem una truita de patata i és un plat molt senzill, que són ous, oli d'oliva, això sí, sempre oli d'oliva, patata, si pot ser de la varietat patata Mona Lisa. Un cop tallada, la posarem a coure a la paella amb oli d'oliva a una temperatura d'uns 160 graus. La idea és que es vagi coent, que quedi com bullida amb oli, no fregida. Posem un ou, una mica de sal, afegir-hi les patates. És important que la patata no estigui freda. Si està calenta, ajuda més a fer la truita. Quan l'oli ja és calent, li posem la barreja de l'ou i un cop ja comença a quallar-se, doncs és qüestió d'anar treballant la truita per poder-li donar la forma que ens agrada i ara ve el moment doncs, de donar-li la volta. Bé, doncs aquí tenim la nostra truita preparada, truita de patata, preparada, la posem al plat per poder-la servir amb un vermutet o una canyeta de cervesa acompanyat d'unes olives.
At Raf Bar, you'll find traditional Spanish fare served in a modern ambiance. Located in the heart of Barcelona, this restaurant features tapas that clients can eat standing up or sitting down during lunch. Make yourself at home and stop by for a bite.
There you go, a really beautiful tortilla de patatas, or let's say Spanish omelette, with beautiful green olives filled with anchovies. And this thing here, it's called a vermouth.
Ooh, a vermouth. I think the main thing we would have to say historically is that vermouth went from medicinal to social. Let's try this wonderful vermouth. Sweet and aromatic, usually accompanied by an olive and a peel of orange.
And you may ask, why is she having these three things all together?
Traditionally, you could have it before lunch, so that meant not to have the alcohol by itself. You accompany it by something to munch on, no? Usually and traditionally, it would be olives and chips, but now everything is admitted, and we can try this wonderful tortilla.
Oh my. The Spanish omelette is something so easy to prepare. It's just eggs, potatoes, and sometimes you can also add onion.
In this case, this tortilla is very moist. It's the way I like it.
See the inside? You can see the texture of the egg, which is not totally cooked. It has to be a little bit raw, so it's creamy.
This tortilla is so traditional. Everybody has it. Actually, I make it every Friday in my house. You'll find a tortilla de patatas in every bar in Barcelona. Actually, in every bar in Spain. That's how popular it is. Olives is something very traditional here. Actually, if you go to a restaurant, the first thing they're gonna do is bring you a little plate of olives just to open the appetite. And as you can see, we have it inside the vermouth and in a little dish. Life is wonderful. When you eat this, you feel great.
The fifth plate on our list is capipota. This is a dish traditionally made for men who used to go to work early in the morning. It's made with veal tripe, veal head, ham, and cooked in onions, tomatoes, garlic, and spices. At Sergi de Meia, the chef has decided to team up with someone very special to prepare this dish.
Je suis Sergi de restaurant Sergi de Meia, Barcelona. Nous fait la cuisine catalane de tradition avec ma maman et après une cuisine catalane modernisée, plus contemporaine. C'est maman qui fait la capipota d'habitude. Elle est meilleure cuisinière que moi en la cuisine traditionnelle. OK, pour faire la capipota, nous commençons pour couper le visage et la tripe de veau, la tripe à la libre. Nous prendrons l'huile d'olive, c'est aussi de l'huile d'olive de mon petit village au Pyrénées. Nous mettons aussi l'oignon et l'ail sur la casserole. Nous mélangerons les poireaux, chorizo et jambon, les lauriers, les rosmarins et les thym. la tomate, c'est tomate en conserve, que nous l'avons fait tous les années ici. Nous prendra le chili, le poivron dû. La prochaine pas, c'est de mettre la tripe et le visage coupé sur le soufragite. Nous mélange tout. Nous mettons le jus de pied de porc. Sans passer les 20 minutes de cuisson, et nous pouvons mettre les pois chiches et la picada. Mais ça, c'est amandes, noisettes et de l'ail. 15-20 minutes plus, et c'est fini. Voilà, ça, c'est le plat de capipota. Merci.
Sergi de Meia seduces the taste buds with the finesse of its dishes, but also through his famous family recipes that the chef shares with us. The place is low-key, cute, and unpretentious. Here, you'll taste refined, historical dishes.
So don't panic, but we're about to eat capipota, which is, I think, that the proper English translation would be a bill, head, and foot. What we are talking about is a Catalan traditional stew.
Capipota, je vais vous avouer, c'est pas mon plat préféré. J'ai déjà goûté une fois et j'ai trouvé que c'était un petit peu lourd.
It's delicious, you know, it has lots of sauce too.
Je vais la sentir un petit peu. Mm. Ça sent bon. Je crois que je vais me réconcilier avec le plat.
This dish has its origin in the peasants and the merchants who went to the markets early in the morning to sell their goods. And if you go to have petit déjeuner in any Catalan market early in the morning, sure as hell that you're going to get a hot, tasty, spicy and saucy dish of capipota.
On a une texture très moelleuse. Des morceaux des abats, en fait, sont vraiment tendres. Mm. C'est super bon. Ça fond dans la bouche. Un vrai régal.
If you are in Barcelona, Catalonia, in any part of Catalonia, you have to try it.
Un point que j'adore dans la cuisine catalane, c'est le fait de faire revenir des plats longtemps, de créer des sauces, en fait. Donc, du coup, on a plein de sucre. C'est une cuisine vraiment de la terre, super savoureuse.
In Catalonia, it's not impolite to take the bread and give it a swing with the sauce. In fact, I would say it's almost like an obligation. Mm.
Dish number 6 on our list is chocolate toast with olive oil. This is an amazingly simple dish, but oh so delicious. It brings together the basic elements of Spanish cuisine: good olive oil, tasty chocolate, crusty bread, and a pinch of sea salt. Who can resist?
Soc en Miquel, estem a Nomad Coffee a Barcelona i bueno, us presentarem la recepta de pa amb oli i xocolata. Intento barrejar diferents xocolates i crear com un blend, no? La mateixa idea que hi ha amb el cafè, doncs amb la xocolata. O sigui, crear barreges per crear un producte específic i singular. El primer és ficar el pa dintre de la torradora. Vale, ara li posarem, una mica lent, que reparteixi per tot el pa. També hem de pensar que el gruix és important. És a dir, hem escollit un pa, un gruix bastant dens. Llavors, és important que n'hi hagi oli perquè arribi fins a baix, també. Una miqueta de sal. Ficarem la xocolata. Doncs aquí el tenim, no? És un plat, com dèiem, senzill, divertit, i que ens recorda una miqueta a la idea quan érem petits, no? I la millor combinació per això és prendre'l amb un bon cafè.
To find Coffee Nomad, you'll have to make your way through some very tiny, scenic streets. Somewhere between two colorful streets, you'll find an alley that'll take you to this charming place, popular with Catalans and hipsters.
We're at Nomad Coffee. This place is an awesome place. You really need to know. We want to have good coffee in the city. And we're also here because I want to introduce you to a very special dish for me because it reminds me to my childhood, but I still eat it and I give it to my kids. It's named pan boli chocolata, and it's something really simple but super good.
Yummy. Perfect balance between sweet and salty.
Because you have the sweet flavor of the chocolate with the salt, and also you have the crunchy part of the grill in the inside. It's kind of soft, but the outside is crunchy. and you get the whole experience. And you really have to, you know, like, get chocolate all over your mouth. If not, you're not having the proper pambol in chocolate.
This reminds me of when I was young, and I used to get out of school, and my parents would come and pick me up, and they would give us a little snack, and they would give us a bread with oil and chocolate. It's something very typical here in Catalonia. All the kids have it after school as a snack. I'm gonna have another bite.
This chocolate is authentic dark chocolate. Forget about Nutellas, buttercreams. I'm telling you, you have to try it. Mmm.
Squid balls are the seventh plate on our list. Catalans traditionally prepare this dish with meat, but at Montvinic, the chef cooks a surf and turf version with fresh Mediterranean sea squid.
Soc en Guillem Oliva, estem al restaurant Montvinic, de Barcelona, i benvinguts. Vale, primer de tot, agafaria i tallo el pa perquè l'hidrataré una miqueta amb el, amb l'ou. Ara li posem aquesta ceba confitada, és una ceba també local. Li hem posat una mica de farigola, uns alls i el cap i els peus de la sèpia. Tot això es rosteix i llavors ho picarem i ho barrejarem amb el pa, també. Ho hem allargat amb una mica de caldo de verdures, el pollastre és indiferent, i comencem a tenir aquesta salsa. Ara el que farem serà... aquí tenim la vesícula, que l'hem aixafat amb l'aigua, l'hem diluït, i posarem una mica aquí i la resta la posarem a la salsa. Val, aquí tenim el resultat de la salsa. Agafem les mandonguilles, li donem una mica de forma. Si veieu, la textura és molt tova, perquè també em vol que sigui així de tova i de melosa. Ara les enfarinem, ara les fregim, que quedin una mica rosses. La textura està daurada per fora, però la textura és toveta, veieu? Les posem dins la salsa i acabarem de coure una estoneta. Anem a emplatar-ho una miqueta. Això són unes herbes també d'aquí del costat. I per acabar posem la salsa que ens ha quedat de fer el rostit, de fer el rostit de la sèpia. I això és la flor de la ficoide, glaciale, que si, com veieu, té com unes gotes aquí de rosada, de la mateixa rosada, i es cria al costat del mar. Per això té aquest punt, aquesta retenció d'aigua tan forta i té aquest punt, aquesta potència de sal. La flor aguanta segons els llocs, però aquí aguanta 10-15 dies. I ja està. Després només hi ha fulla.
For wine lovers, Montvinic is a mandatory destination. It's right in the heart of the city. This is a restaurant with a renowned wine menu and one of the largest wine cellars in Europe and the world. Combine amazing wines with the chef's superb menu, and you're sure to spend a perfect evening.
If you're interested in looking for the perfect match between wine and food, this is your place. I'm drinking an Exhibis Pla de Bages wine from 2013.
Oh, amazing.
Oh my God. The aspect is so gorgeous, it hurts me to eat it, but I'll make an effort. Jesus.
I hope the taste is explosive as well. Amazing.
Clearly you can see the black, inky, stripped down to pieces cuttlefish. So in a sense, the guy has recreated a Catalan classical dish in a whole new aspect and taste.
It's crunchy outside because it's deep fried. And the sauce that we see here is made of beef. So that would be the mar y montaña, the mountain and the sea dish. And the tradition is that all the fishermen, the fish that they couldn't sell, they would just put it inside a casserole and they would cook something. So that's the origin of these dishes called mar y montaña, very typical here. So this amazing dish is accompanied by an amazing wine from El Bages, which is an area here in Catalonia.
In this place, which is one of the most important for the wine culture in Europe, they hold about 3,000 wine references.
I think this is the proof of how good it was. I could lick the plate, but I'm not gonna do it because I'm on TV.
The eighth plate on our list is black sausage served with green peas. This is a recipe that highlights fresh market cuisine and traditional Spanish cooking techniques. The black sausage is homemade and cooked to perfection.
Jo sóc el Nando Jubany, sóc el cap de cuina i una mica ideòleg d'aquest restaurant, que és el Petit Comitè, que estem al passatge de la Concepció, al centre de Barcelona. Bueno, començarem posant la cassola al foc, una mica d'oli d'oliva verge. Hi ha molts plats tradicionals que barregem grasses, o llard de porc i mantega, o llard de porc i oli, en aquest cas, oli i una mica de mantega. Jo penso que és l'influència de la cuina francesa que hem tingut a Catalunya, no? Si hi posem ceba tendra... Bueno, per fer servir aquest plat, el que utilitzarem és la cansalada. Nosaltres la fem envasada al buit, perquè ara hi ha unes altres tècniques, envasada al buit durant 10 hores a 75 graus. I agafaríem la part que té la part magra de dins. Ara serà l'hora de posar-hi l'enciam tou, amb una mica d'aigua, molt poqueta, i posem el pèsol. I ara anirem per posar la botifarra negra, que és una botifarra feta amb orella, amb morro, en diuen botifarra de parracs, aquí. És una botifarra que té molt cartílag i és el que porta, el que trobarem quan la desfarem juntament amb els pèsols, trobarem aquests cruixents que hi ha aquí dins aquesta botifarra. Agafarem la botifarra, posem la cansalada, posem la botifarra negra i posem la cansalada cruixent.
The Petit Comité is a fabulous restaurant located near La Rambla and its high-end boutiques. Nando Jubany is a five-star Michelin chef who revamps classic Catalan dishes his own way. Here's a lunch that you're going to remember for a long time.
I'm about to have a super seasonal dish here in Petit Comité. In this case, I'm saying super seasonal because it is super seasonal. Exactly in 1 week, these peas are gone.
C'est un plat typique traditionnel de la Catalogne. Ça sent tellement bon, il y a tellement de parfum.
They're very small peas, and they're crunchy outside, soft inside, super fresh.
Donc là, il nous a mis des petits morceaux de lard. C'est un lard que je crois qu'il prépare au four pendant des heures, et ça sent délicieusement bon. Incroyable.
You should mix everything together.
Incroyable. En une bouchée, c'est parti, c'est encore plus fondant que les petits pois.
And this dish is one of the dishes that Nando Jubany, the Michelin star chef that works here in Petit Comité, used to have when he was young.
Et ce que j'apprécie énormément ici, c'est que des chefs comme Nando Jubany perpétuent un peu la tradition et actualisent ces plats de façon gastronomique. On mange aussi un petit peu avec le patrimoine culturel de la Catalogne ici.
The peas come from the north of Barcelona and you can find it in many restaurants. Although it's probably not going to be so good like this one.
The ninth plate on our list is crema catalana. This is a rich and creamy dessert made with fresh milk, eggs, sugar and flavored with cinnamon. They say that this dish, a type of creme brulee, was made for St. Joseph of Catalonia's birthday. That's why today it's known as crema catalana. It's also the most popular dessert in the south of Spain.
La crema catalana de can viade. Primer, el que hem de fer és agafar la llet fresca, la vertim aquí. Això és la llema d'ou. Això el que fa és donar color i espai. Sucre, la canyella i la pell de llimona. I, finalment, cogerem un poc de llet fria i la mesclarem amb la harina de maïs. Aquí tenim el caldo de la crema catalana. Aquí el que hem de fer ara és deixar el bany-maria 40 minuts, anar remenant mica en mica, perquè no se'ns enganxi el que seria la part de sota, i ara colar-lo. Passar pel colador i veureu com així queda molt més fi. Una vegada hem emplatat, l'únic que hem de fer és deixar-ho atemperar amb temperatura ambient, un cop estigui natural, nevera, i uns 10 dies aguantar la crema catalana. La crema catalana no és res sense el sucre cremat. Muy bien, ahora esto es poner una capa bien llena de azúcar al centro, ¿eh? Sobre todo, a los laterales no hace falta. Crème brûlée.
Granja Viader first opened its doors in 1870, and almost nothing has changed. This is a real institution where you can eat desserts, cheese, and all sorts of dairy products, and it's located near La Boqueria Market. The place is surrounded by public squares and lively streets. Definitely worth a visit.
Une belle crème catalane. Enfin, la petite touche sucrée, la touche dessert de cette belle journée.
Here I am, about to have a crema catalana, or is it a crème brûlée? Who cares? Maybe Picasso sat in this chair.
Vous savez quelle est la différence entre la crème catalane et la crème brûlée? Les Catalans, ils mettent de la maïzena pour l'épaissir, et les Français, de la crème fraîche. Voilà.
You break it.
Moi, ce que j'adore avec la crème catalane, c'est rompre la petite croûte. J'adore le bruit, j'adore quand arrive ce moment à la fin du repas.
Amazing. Light and creamy and sweet and cinnamon and crunchy. Oh, perfect texture. Mm.
Qu'est-ce que c'est bon. Moi, je suis aux anges avec ce genre de dessert. L'avantage, c'est qu'ici, en Catalogne, on le trouve quasiment sur toutes les cartes de tous les restaurants. On l'a à chaque fois, c'est assuré.
This place also was called Granja Viader. Granja means farm. Because all the milk and everything that came to this place came from a farm far away from Barcelona in Cardedeu. Actually, on the walls, we have pictures of the cows that were providing the milk to this place.
Vous voulez goûter?
Bon profit!
The 10th plate on our list is called Angry Eggs and Ham. This rather silly translation nonetheless reflects the way Catalans eat this traditional dish that's made with potatoes, ham and eggs served sunny side up.
Soc en Jordi Samper, chef executiu del grup Pantea. Avui ens trobem a la platja de la Barceloneta. Estem al Vall Moana i avui us prepararem els ous estrellats i un pa amb tomàquet. I amb un oli ben calent, el que farem és fregir aquesta patata. Ara el que anem a fer és a fregir els ous amb oli d'oliva, quan l'oli està ben calentet, i aboquem l'ou. I ara aquests ous, que ja els tenim ferrats, n'hi ha un que està una miqueta més fregit que l'altre, perquè ens interessa que estigui una mica cru perquè es trenqui i surti tot el rovell. Farem el muntatge del plat. Aquí teniu el pernil, és el pernil de gla, denominació d'origen Extremadura. Posem les patates fregides i amb la calor residual de la patata el que fem és posar el pernil. Llavors, aquest ou que està més cru, el posem i ara posarem l'altre ou. I aquest ou el posarem aquí sobre. I aquí teniu els ous cabrejats de la Barceloneta.
When you think of Barcelona, you think of the sea, the beach, the sunsets, and hot summer days. Make the pleasure last by visiting Vall Moana Restaurant. Vall Moana is ideal for a drink or dinner a few feet from the beach. This is paradise.
Isn't it beautiful? I could cry. Fried egg with ciboulette, the Spanish ham, and the fries.
Et là, c'est parti, je vais attaquer la fraîche là.
Angry? Why?
Parce que tout simplement, on va le détruire, ce beau montage-là.
What you need to do is punch the yolk and just splash it, mix it, cut.
C'est là que la magie opère.
Hi, that's my kid. Bisous, papa. Go with papa. Yeah, I love you, I love you. Go with papa.
Un petit peu de tout, un peu de patate, un peu de jambon, un peu d'œuf. Ça, c'est l'orgasme gastronomique, ça. C'est grandiose.
Mm. Look. This is a side dish that you cannot miss in any of your dishes here in Barcelona. It's called pan tomàquet. This is a dish that really belongs to our culture. Remember, pan con tomate when you come to Barcelona, or you'll regret it, I'm telling you.
Pour moi, Français expatrié, venir manger un plat comme ça, dans un cadre comme ça, c'est la super qualité de vie. Des ingrédients simples peuvent faire de grands plats.
For our last dish, we suggest calçots, Catalan onions that are cooked on the grill and eaten from the end of January to spring. Catalan families gather to eat this dish that's deeply rooted in Spanish culture. This tradition is called calçotada.
Soc el Jordi.
Jo la Sara.
I som els propietaris de la salsa menta.
Avui farem una porció de calçots per a aquest grup de foodies que venen. Els calçots els mengem amb salsa salpitxada. És una salsa que cuinem amb tomàquets i alls escalivats al forn. Aleshores, triturem ametlles i avellanes, afegim la carn del tomàquet i els alls, ho triturem tot junt. Aleshores, afegim la carn de l'anyora, que és un pebrot dolç, sec, oli d'oliva, una mica de sal i tot barrejat, que quedi una textura apropiada per poder sucar els calçots.
Ara que ja tenim el foc en marxa, posem els calçots al damunt i simplement cremar-los a la flama. Un cop els tenim ben calcinats, ben cremats, els emboliquem en papers de diari i els fiquem al forn perquè s'acabin de cuinar i conservin bé tots els seus sucs i siguin més fàcils de pelar.
A més, és un menjar que he fet en grups i de forma molt divertida. Normalment acabes bastant embrutat, però per això ens posarem uns pitets abans de menjar-lo i ja veureu el resultat.
In a few moments, our foodies will be back to taste some traditional calçots. As tradition dictates, it's finally time for our foodies to come together and taste some grilled calçots. We're at La Salsa Menta, a cooking school that can also be reserved for a traditional group dinner. If this week's foodie list inspired you to want to cook Catalan style, perhaps you could travel here to take lessons.
This looks terrific, isn't it?
It's gorgeous.
It's amazing. I can wait to have one. So I don't know what about you guys, but here's my technique. You have to pick the inner leaves. Just pull that over. Voila! And then you have the most delicious vegetable for me in Catalonia.
That's a good technique. Yeah. Mm.
We can't get any more Catalan than this table.
Sure.
We have the calçots, our hands are dirty, we're sharing with the people we love.
I don't know what about you, but I could have like calçotada
every weekend.
Every weekend.
Which is incredible is that the story of calçot was an accident because this farmer put the sweet onions in the brass and he forgot about them.
Ah, yeah, that's true.
So then he went back and he saw the onion that was burned all black. Yeah. And he said, you know what? I'm gonna try it. So he peeled it and he discovered that inside it was still very soft and very moist and very nice, and he tried it, and that's how the tradition became. Yeah. But
the curious thing I discovered is that you have to do it with the flame, not with the
yes,
like a barbecue.
Live
it
has flame. To be
directly.
Live.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah. It's totally different than one would expect from eating a regular onion. It's sweeter, also it's crunchier. Unlike the onions, it doesn't make you cry.
No.
It's like, oh, it's so sweet that it makes you smile. And
I'm absolutely craving for more meatballs with cuttlefish, which were amazing in Montbinic.
Really?
Oh, amazing.
I gotta try. So, what about you, Olivier?
My favorite dish was the huevo cabreado. At the end, it's very easy ingredients, but when you mix it, it's like the magic happens.
Oh, it was great, and
yeah.
You know, like the sea breeze.
Oh. It was yours too, Marta, your favorite one.
Yeah, I can tell. You can tell. What about you?
I have to say that the capipota that Sergi de Mellada, it's a dish that's like a kind of summary of the Catalan tradition, you know.
I've never tried.
You have to go for it. I mean, it's like
Sergi de Mellada made a very nice version, good version.
I wish we could have glasses to cheers and drink for the our gastronomical culture and Catalan, but I guess we'll have something like, what about that? There you go.
Wait.
Catalan cuisine is all about tradition. While today's dishes have a new style about them, Catalans have not forgotten their roots and make sure to carry on cooking traditional Spanish dishes, such as crayfish, crema catalana, rice plates, capipota, and calçots. It's practically impossible to resist such passionate cuisine. Join us again soon for another episode of The Foodie List.